Namaste students, hope you all fine. Myself Saranya, I am your social teacher. Today we are going to start the next lesson in geography, lesson number 4, maps. So about maps we are going to see in this lesson. Children, you have learned about globe in the previous lesson, right? So globe is the limitations. Globe have limitations, as well as the globe can be useful when we want to study the earth as whole. So it is thus miniature of earth, right children? So like that, in that, as about our country, states, districts, towns and villages, it is of little, so everything will be in little size. You cannot identify district, towns, villages in the globe, right children? So for that case, we are using maps. A map is a representation. So first we saw about the globe. Next, we are going to see about a map. Map is a representation or a drawing of earth's surface, or a part of it drawn on a flat surface according to the scale. So simply saying means it's like a part of the earth. So it was not completely flat in the globe image, but it is like that, similar to that. So collection of maps we can see in the atlas. So various maps put together we get a atlas. So you all know about the atlas book, right children? In atlas book you can see part of the maps. You can see one by one country in detail. So like this map is useful to us, but it is impossible to flatten the round surface completely. I told you already, it is very impossible to get a exact flat surface. So we find that maps are useful to us for various purposes. One map shows a small area and a few facts, and another map contains as many facts as a big book. So that is called atlas. So when many maps are put together, we get an atlas. Atlas is of various size, measurements drawn on different scales. Maps provided more information than the globe. There are different types, some of them are described below. So in atlas we can see each country very detailedly. You can find out all the cities, districts, towns, villages, so everything you can get to know. So it will be in a clear form. So some of the types are we are going to see in this lesson. So let's see. First type of map is physical map. So what is physical map? So you can see in this picture, right children? It will be only few colors are there, like green, brown, white, blue. So what these colors are saying to us? Green areas are forest, the brown areas are mountain areas, like that it is showing. So these type of map we call it as physical map or relief maps. So in this map we can be easily identify the mountain areas, plateaus, plains, rivers, oceans, etc. So we call this map as physical map. Okay children, next one is political map. So what is political map means? In this map, what and all you can see? You can see the country names and states names, right children? So we can see something in detail, not full details, but when compared to physical map, you can see some names in this. So you can identify, oh, this was this country. So in this country, this state was there. So like that, we can easily identify. And we can also see the boundaries also. So This map is called political map. Next is thematic map. Some maps focus on physical information such as road maps, rainfall maps. So maps showing distribution of forest, industries, etc. are known as thematic maps. So children, what is thematic map means? You can see in this map some colors they have identified. So like this, they have identified, they have given the explanation also in the short form. So we can be measuring the rainfalls. So in the light areas, the rainfall light color areas which have shown in the map, we can consider that the rainfall will be very less. And the next shade was little bit high when compared to the last one. So like that, it will be increased, like dark brown, where these areas rainfall will be more. So like that, we can differentiate and identify in this map. So this is a basic information which it will be provided. So this map is called thematic maps. So there are three components of maps we are going to see here. One is distance, another one is direction, another one is symbol. So in this lesson we are going to see about these components of maps in details. What are the distance, direction and symbol? First, distance. So what does mean by distance, children? Like from your school to home, how much distance do you have? 2 kilometers or 5 kilometers? So that is called distance. Like that, in map also some distance they have maintaining. So about that we are going to see here. So read the paragraph. Maps are drawings which reduce the entire world or a part of it to fit on a sheet of paper. It is right, children. So how the earth is, how the world is, it is very big. But we have to measure all these things and we have to compress it in a sheet of paper. So how it is possible? With using the scale, like distance. Or we can say maps are drawn to reduced scales. But this reduction is done very carefully, so that the distance between the places is real. So for creating these types of maps, how they are having, really they have to be very careful. So each and every distance they have to measure and they have to fix it in a one sheet of paper. It can only be possible when a small distance on a paper represents a large distance on the ground. So in the map you can see a small distance means you have to convert that into some measurement will be there. So we will be seeing in this. So that thing we call it as scale. Scale is the ratio between the actual distance of the ground and the distance shown on the map. So children, what is scale? The actual distance on the ground ratio between the distance shown on the map. So for example, the distance between your school and your home is 10 kilometers. So 10 kilometers you will be having. If you show this 10 kilometers distance by 2 centimeters on a map, it means 1 centimeter on the map will be show 5 centimeter on the ground. So you are compressing the 10 kilometers into 2 centimeter. Like 1 centimeter is equal to 5 kilometer. So this is called scale of your drawing. Thus scale is very important in any map. If you know the scale, you will be able to calculate the distance between any two places on the map. So always you can see, whenever you are seeing the map in the atlas or wherever you go, so any corner of the map they will be given the scale measurement. So with the help of the scale measurement, you can identify the distance between the places on a map. So try in your home, any map is there means you can take and try this. When a large areas like continents or countries are to be shown on a paper, then we use a small scale. For example, 5 cm on the map shows 500 kilometers. Imagine, only 5 cm can cover 500 kilometers. So before that we saw some school to home calculation, right children? In that, 2 cm covers only 10 kilometers. Like that we have given the example. But while covering the continents and countries, we have to cover so many kilometers under 1 or 2 centimeters. So like the here, 5 centimeter can cover 500 kilometers on the ground. So it is called small scale map. So small scale map means a small centimeter can cover big kilometer. Next one is large scale map. When a small area like your village or town is to be shown on a paper, then we use large scale. That is, 5 cm on the map shows 500 meters. See here children, only 500 meters, we will be lengthening that and write as 5 cm. So, small centimeter, big meters or kilometers. Small kilometers. Big centimeter and small kilometers, that is called large scale. Small centimeter and big kilometer is called small scale. So like this, we are dividing the map into a small scale map and large scale map. For more information than, so large scale maps give more information because it will be very clear, right? Even we can see that 500 meters in 5 centimeter. So every street, everything we can be known in that map. So it will be very clear and we get more information while comparing to small scale maps. So you can see the map here. Hey, children, so this is the two maps which is the same place they have taken. So in this small scale map you can see. It will be so messy, right? So, because we have compressed in the whole map into a small scale. So, it shows very messy. While comparing to large scale, it will be clear while comparing to small scale. So, this is the difference between large scale and small scale map. Next, we are going to see about directions. Most of the maps contain an arrows marked with the letter M at the upper right hand corner. This arrow shows the north direction. So wherever you see the map, they will be showing which side is north, which side is south and west and east. It will be showing, right? So N for north and S for south, E for east and W for west. It is called the north line. When you know the north, you can find out the other directions. So one direction we know means we can identify all the three directions. So for example, east, west, south. There are four major directions. So which I told you already, north, south, east, west. So they are called cardinal points. So what it is called? They are called cardinal points. Other four intermediate directions are, so NE means northeast, SE means southeast, SW southwest, NW is northwest. We can locate any place more accurate with the help of these intermediate directions. So in between north and west, it will be northwest. So it is called as intermediate directions. So in this map, this compass is very important. So we can be able to see whether this place is situated in which direction. Like it will be situated in northeast or it will be situated in southwest. We can be identified easily with the help of these direction. Find out the following direction from the figure 4.1. So this is the figure 4.1. So children, you have to direct this. First one, direction of the community center. Where the community center here? So here the community center is here. The direction of community center, the playground from Vikas house. So the community center and the playground you have to find out from Vikas. So Vikas house is here. You have to calculate the map or direct the map to community center. After that they are going to playground. So you have to direct this. This is your homework, children. Do this. Second thing, the direction of school from shops. So where is the school here? School is situated here. From here you have to direct it to the shops. So these two things you have to direct. And next, we can find out the direction of place with the help of a compass. It is an instrument used to find out many direction. It a magnetic needle always points towards the north-south direction. So children, you can see, even in your mobile, you have compass. So if you are having a mobile or parents' mobile, take that and open the compass. You can be seeing that one straight needle will be there. It will be always pointing out the north-south direction. Remaining direction we can assume from that. So it will be very helpful for the peoples to find out where they are. So which direction they are going. So like that it is very important. So next we are going to see about symbols. It is the third important component of a map. So already we have seen the distance and direction. The last thing is about symbols. So it is not possible to draw on a map the actual shape and the size of the different features such as buildings, roads, bridges, trees, railway lines or a well. So children, think it is possible to draw all these things accurately in the map? Never, right? So they are shown by using certain letters, shades or colors, pictures and lines. So instead of drawing the exact picture, they are using some symbols to identify that. For that, these symbols give a lot of information in a limited space. So in the small space, it will be covering all the things. With the use of these symbols, map can be drawn easily and or simple to read. Even if you don't know the language of an area and therefore cannot ask someone for direction, you can collect information from maps with the help of these symbols. So children, some of them will know English, some of them will know Kannada and some of them will know other languages. So if you are going to other countries, you don't know the language and you don't know how to ask to other persons, by you can use these types of symbols in the maps which have shown. So it will be very helpful. If you are not understanding the language also, you can identify with these symbols. Maps have a universal language that can be understood by all. There is an international agreement regarding the use of these symbols. These are called conventional symbols. Some of the conventional symbols are shown in figure 4.3. So what is the conventional symbols means? Look at the picture here. You can be identified. So first, look at the cursor here. The first, this dark shades. This will be indicating the railway line. Next, this symbol is indicating the boat gauge, that is railway station. And the last one is indicating the meter gauge. So like this, they are writing. So like post office, they will be using PO. Post and telegraph office, they will be using PTO. Police station, they will be using PS. So like that. So if it is a temple, church, mosque or chhatri, they will be using these types of symbols. So if there will be a trees and grass, they will be using these types of symbols. So this is a universal language. Anyone can understand this easily. So like this, they have used these types of symbols in the map. It is called conventional symbol. So it can be read by anyone. Various colors are used for the same purpose. For example, generally blue is used for showing water bodies, brown for mountains, yellow for plateau, and green is used for plains. So usually you can see in the pictures, children, we already seen one map in the picture, right? In the physical map. So you can see only the colors. So you can see blue colors in the water body areas, brown color for mountain areas, and yellow color for plateaus, and green color for plains. So this is also a universal one. Anyone can understand this by looking at the color. Next is sketch. A sketch is a drawing mainly based on a memory and a spot observation, and not to a scale. So sketch is a spot observation, children. So it is like a rough diagram. Sometimes a rough diagram is required of an area to tell where a particular place is located with the respect to other places. So for example, children, if you are going to your friend's home, for that you don't know the map. For that your friend will be drawing the rough map by locating the some places or some shops. So like this, you can see in this picture, they have roughly draw the map. So these types of maps, we call it as sketch map, the rough diagram without scales. Okay, children. So this types of map is called sketch map. Next is plan. A plan is a drawing of a small area on a large scale. A large scale map gives lot of information, but there are certain things which we may sometimes want to know. For example, the length and breadth of the room. So you can see, children, if you are having a own house, so for that the architect or engineer will be planning for the house, how to build, what centimeter your hall should be there, and what centimeter or what inches they will be having some measurements. So like that, they will be having some blueprints. So if you are having, means your elders will be having that, so you can ask that. So it will be very detailed. So your hall is how much centimeter it is, your bedroom is how much centimeter, even your bathroom is having how much centimeter. Like this, they will be calculated before they build one building. So that type of even they will be calculating the length and breadth of a room. So like that, they will be calculating everything, and they will be drawing in a scale, like everything in the measurement. So it is called plan. So you can see in this picture, children, they have planned some area of land. So in that land they are measuring everything, what this place will be having, what they are having, like that. So this is called plan. Next, see this map, children's. You can be identify. We already saw what is PTO, Post Telegram Office. PS is police station. So like this, they have drawn in this map. So we are going to identify these questions. So find out in which direction is the river flowing. So the river is flowing here, right, children? So it is flowing in which direction? You can be write your answer with the help of the direction. So children, here direction is there. So I can't remove this one. So in your book you can see in this area the direction symbol will be there. So you can see that and you can tell where from where the river is flowing. You can write your answer. And the second thing is, what kind of road passes by the side of village Dambri? So village Dambri is there, right, children? And what kind of road is passing by that? So you can see these types of symbols. You already know what are the meaning of these symbols. You can refer that symbol table and you can write the answer for these questions. Okay, children, this is also your homework. Next, again another map. So in this map you can see the scale is there, the meter scale. So here 1 centimeter equal to 100 meters. Okay, children, so it is a meter scale. Look at the figure 4.1. that is a scale. It may be used for measuring distance between places. For example, the distance between the well and the tree is 5 centimeter. So where is the well here? Well and the tree. So from here to there will be 5 centimeters. It means that the actual distance of is 500 meters. So they have told, right? 1 centimeter equal to 100 meters. So here 5 centimeter is there. 5 centimeter means 550 meters. Now the distance between the PO. What is PO? That is post office. Post office to Karmi's house. So you can see the Karmi's house is here and the post office is here. They have draw the arrow marks to go there, like mentioning A, B, M, C, D, E, like that. They have mentioned that. So from these you can identify how many kilometers are there to reach the post office from Karmi's house. So like that you can identify E to C and C to M, M to B and B to A. So like that you can calculate the distance from Karmi's house to post office, how many kilometers are there. Add all these distance, this will be total walking distance from Karmi's house to post office. So easily you can be identify how much distance you can take to reach the place. For this, these types of scales are very useful in the map. Okay, children, that's all, children. The lesson got over. Hope you all understood the lesson. If you're not, means read it again carefully. Definitely you can understand the lesson. Okay, children, read the lesson and do your homework. Complete it. Okay, children, thank you.